The Michael Flynn, James Comey, Trump Russia story just got even more complicated for Donald Trump. See, on March 20th, former FBI Director James Comey went to Congress and he said, hey, this is where we're at with this investigation. We're going to keep going. In response to that, according to new reports, Donald Trump reached out to Director of National Intelligence Daniel Coates and Admiral Michael Rogers to tell them to push back against the FBI and this investigation. Basically, push back when they try to ask questions. Push back when they ask for information or ask for access to information. Now, what Donald Trump may not realize is that this act is considered obstruction of justice. If you are talking to someone and you're in a position of power over these people, like Donald Trump was with these directors of national intelligence, and you tell them to not cooperate, that is textbook obstruction of justice, which, yes, is a very impeachable offense. Now, this is what the Washington Post is reporting, still waiting for even more firm confirmation that this story is true. At this point, we have no reason to doubt it whatsoever. Other outlets are reporting this same information. So at this point, taken at face value, we have at least two separate instances where Donald Trump blatantly committed obstruction of justice. Now, one of the major arguments from legal experts on both sides after the Comey conversation was made public, where Trump allegedly told Comey to make the investigation go away, the question at that point was intent. Was he saying, hey, man, make this go away because we've got a lot of things to deal with national security, and this is just a distraction? Or was he threatening him, saying, make it go away now, I don't want this happening? Because depending on the intent, it may not be an impeachable offense. But this instance, talking to these two national intelligence directors, is absolutely obstruction. Because at this point, these men have no sway over the investigation. They're people who very could likely and would be likely to be questioned. And Trump is telling them to not cooperate, to push back, or if they weren't going to be questioned, to go and intimidate and make this investigation not happen. This is illegal. This is the kind of thing where if any other person in this country did this, we would go to jail. Imagine if news broke during the Obama administration that Obama did something like this. What would the reaction from the Republicans be? They'd be calling for him to be crucified on Capitol Hill and then probably crucify a couple more people just for good measure. But this, now that it's Donald Trump who is blatantly breaking the law and just getting away with it apparently, there is no massive outcry from Republicans. There's not even a loud enough cry from the Democrats at this point. All of those wait and see people need to start waking up and realizing that this wait and see is only going to make things worse. You know, we thought at one point it couldn't get worse than that Comey memo. There, boom, there's your evidence, obstruction of justice. But now, according to this Washington Post report, we've got even more of a bombshell at this point that should be more than enough to get Donald Trump kicked out of office if we had people in the House of Representatives willing to go forth and understand that impeachment is a very real and tangible possibility at this point, given this new evidence. If you like this video, make sure that you like, comment, and share, and most importantly, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you want to help support Ring of Fire, go to patreon.com/theringoffire, become a monthly patron to help support independent progressive media.